This is Shubhapriyo, and in today's video, we'll be talking about equivalence relation and bijection functions involved in relations and functions. Please do follow us on our Facebook, Instagram, and Telegram channels for your daily dose of math and physics. Let's get started with our JEE problems.
So this is the first question where a relation has been given as an ordered pair, and the relation is in the set real number, and you have to check whether the relation is an equivalence relation or different types of relations or not. So first, what is an equivalence relation? An equivalence relation is made up of three different types of relation. One is a reflexive relation, another one is a symmetric relation, and the final one is a transitive relation. So what is a reflexive relation? If, for example, an element belongs to a set A, then we will call, if it is a reflexive relation, then A, A should belong to the relation. That is, the element should be related to itself. Symmetric means if there are two elements A, B belonging to a set A and A, B belong to a relation R, then that implies that B, A should also belong to the relation. Then it is a symmetric relation. Transitive means if A, B, C belong to a set A and A, B belong to a relation R and B, C belong to a relation R, then that means that A, C will also belong to the relation R. So if this condition holds, then we will call it a transitive relation. So in our question, the relation is given as A is greater than equal to B. If you see properly, the relation is A greater than equal to B. So this is definitely a reflexive relation because greater than equal to sign is there. That means A equal to B is also mentioned in the relation. And we know that any element is equal to itself. Therefore, reflexive relation holds. Now let us check symmetry. Symmetry means if A greater than equal to B, then that should imply B is greater than equal to A. But let's see the question. A is greater than equal to B. Therefore, let us take two numbers, 2 and 1. We know that 2 is greater than equal to 1, but we know that 1 is not greater than equal to 2. Definitely, this relation is not a symmetric relation. Transitive or not? Definitely, it's a transitive relation. If A is greater than equal to B and B is greater than equal to C, then no matter what happens, A is always greater than equal to C. Because if you choose any three numbers, for example, 3, 2 and 1, we know that 3 is greater than equal to 2 and 2 is greater than equal to 1. And we also know that 3 is greater than equal to 1. Therefore, definitely it's a transitive relation. So in order to sum up, we will say that this relation is a reflexive, transitive, but not symmetric relation. So our option will be option number B. So today's second question is a far advanced question, and this type of question is definitely expected from JEE Maths. So let's go straight into the question. There is a relation R equal to 1, 2 and 2, 3 on the set 1, 2, 3. So basically it's a relation between two ordered pairs and on the set of three positive integers. The minimum number of ordered pairs which when added to R will make it an equivalence relation is. So in the previous problem, we discussed what is an equivalence relation. It should be symmetric, reflexive and transitive. So the first thing to note is if there are three integers, we will definitely write that for reflexive relation, we need three pairs definitely to fulfill. That is 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3. Now if 1, 2 is there, we need 2, 1 to make it a symmetric relation. 2, 3 is there, we need 3, 2 to make it a symmetric relation. Okay, and we have also 1, 2 and 2, 3. So definitely there will be an 1, 3 which will make it a transitive relation. So this is a reflexive, this is a symmetric part and this is the transitive part. And since 1, 3 is there, then 3, 1 should also be there. This is again the symmetric part to the transitive part. So this is the third question. The third question is basically a functions question. In this question, they have asked to find out the functions which are bijections from Z to itself. So the first question is, what is Z? Z is definitely integer. So all negative integers, 0 and positive integers will form Z. That is, any non-decimal number can be considered to be in Z. Now the second question is, what is a bijection? A bijection function is made up of two forms. One is a one-to-one function and the other is an onto function. So what is an one-to-one function? One-to-one means for every x there is a single f of x. For example, f of x equal to x, f of x equal to log x,
f of x equal to e to the power ax, all of these are one-to-one function. What is an onto function? An onto function simply means that if we consider the domain and range of a function, if this is the domain and this is the range of the function, then we will say that every element in the range has been mapped. That is, there is no single element which is empty in f of x. So this is the definition of an onto function. So let's come back to our question. There are four questions here: x cube, x plus 2, 2x plus 1, and x square plus x. The first thing to notice is x square plus x can never be a one-to-one function, because we know that negative and positive number squared will give me the same value. Therefore, it's a many-to-one function. It's not a one-to-one function. So the first thing we will do is to cut off option number 4. It's not possible. Let's go to question part, like the first option, x is cube. So x is cube is definitely a one-to-one function, because negative number cube will always give a negative number, positive number cube will always give a positive number. But whether it's an onto function or not, it's not an onto function, because we know that there are numbers such as 2, 3, 4, 5. If this belong to x, we know that x will be equal to cube root of 2, cube root of 3, and all these numbers which does not belong to z. But the function has told that it should be from z to itself. Therefore, this is not an onto function. This is not an onto function. Therefore, we will strike off x cube as well. Now, let's come to option number C, 2x plus 1. 2x plus 1 is definitely a one-to-one function. Using this function, we can map any number on the z. But it's not an onto function, because if we see f of x equal to 0, because that is also a part of integer, so 2x plus 1 equal to 0, that means x equal to minus 1 by 2, which does not belong to z. Therefore, 0 will not be mapped, and therefore it is not an onto function. Therefore, option C is also not correct. Let's come to our last option, which is definitely the answer, but still I will do it. X plus 2 is definitely a one-to-one function as well as an onto function, because we cannot think of any number which will not get mapped because of this function. So option B is our right option. Okay, so that's it. Today we covered a very easy but not so simple topic, relations and functions. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Mathofy, for your daily dose of math and physics.